Okay, let's finish this. Once and for all. We're back with Kirby Superstar. We're the Spiffy Needle Geeks. This is part 6.
And Leo's just kind of like, you know, whipping his hair back and forth.
As always.
As always.
That's such a weird animation for, like, a walking helper. I mean, everyone else is like, you know, okay, they're just walking or floating or something, but it's like, what's with the hair whipping?
It's like, are you kidding? That's the best walking animation ever. Oh, wait, you got Jet.
There's a treasure here, and this one took me a while to get. Jet's probably your best option to get this, just because it's going to be really hard to maneuver around the wind with any other power.
There you go.
You need to cut through the wind in order to get the treasure chest that's down there.
Oh, shit, they have katanas in this game?
Yes.
Holy shit! That is awesome.
Capsule J. I think this is the first time we see this helper, actually.
Yes, I don't recognize this one.
Capsule J. I'm just looking around a bit, because I didn't know what to expect if there were, like, any, like, hidden areas around here.
Ah. Okay.
But I'm going to go ahead and save, because I hate that last area that we were in.
Oh, we know.
Anyway.
Well, think about it this way. I mean, I never played this game, so I highly doubt it would miss any secrets or anything like that. But I will say, you should probably be really relieved that BJ wasn't here to join you on this.
No, whatever.
Yeah, it's like, oh, darn college.
Yeah, you know, the important stuff.
It's like, hey, Capsule J, what are you doing, buddy?
You missed it!
So does the jet power-up just make you, like, you know, blast forward? Like, does it just gives you a dash?
I mean, you can attack with it. It's just... It's... what's the one I'm looking for? It's very situational.
There we go.
But it is helpful for this area. Make sure you don't hit that the last bomb that's down there. Otherwise, you lose that treasure.
So just
hit the top three.
Christmas tree.
It's an Xmas tree.
This guy's for Christ.
Completely different.
Yeah, Futurama has taught me anything. It's an Xmas. It's the politically correct one.
I'll screw you. It's Merry Christmas. You love a different religion, and they're world.
Anyway, let's not.
It's like all that's missing is a murderous robot Santa.
Now I'm just thinking of the Christmas special with Jeff Dunham.
Oh, it's so good. I need to find a way to watch that again.
Oh my god.
Unless we gotta wait until this Christmas, which is actually 4 months away from now.
That is true.
Do you have a random snowman?
Oh yeah, I had to make a jump here because
you got Frosty with you.
Yeah, there was a bit of a jump cut there, just because I was doing some trial and error through this area.
Hey, Kirby found your ring, Brandon.
My ring? Yes. But yeah, when you're going through this area to get the treasure chest, make sure you cut the first rope thing that you see right there. Otherwise, every other area is going to trap you. There is a tomato there. I'm gonna get that tomato.
Tomatoes or tamales?
You decide. What? Anyway.
Sorry.
Yeah, you got the tomato even though you didn't need it.
Well, I was gonna give it to Chili, but he was kind of all over the place, so it's like whatever. Yeah. And now we're back to Yo-Yo.
Back to.
And now Chili's dead.
No. Brandon, what did you do? You killed him.
I didn't do anything.
You killed him.
Oh, there he goes. There we go.
He wanted to die a proper death by melting in the heat, but no, you had to make him...
That's not proper, that's gruesome.
But that's what it's not supposed to be, because it's snow. You don't see snow.
That's not proper at all.
Oh, wait,
Triforce!
Yes.
So does this mean Kirby can, like, you know, make a wish and the Hyrule gods have to grant it now?
I don't think Kirby knows exactly what that is.
If anything, he probably well, once he finds a Triforce, he just eats it.
Oh God.
He would.
It's like, we don't want to go here just yet.
Or either that, or just use it to wish for even more food than what Popstar has to offer.
Oh God.
I wonder what's for dinner, and he just tells pretty much every enemy in sight.
Well, he does that anyway.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I know.
I know.
It's a terrible joke. Okay.
I know. Anyway.
It's a terrible joke. Okay.
Third door. It's like in terms of like length, like this area is like significantly shorter than all the others. Mainly because there's just not much air.
Oh no! Oh treasure! Oh, yeah.
We're good. Pegasus wing.
That's a feather,
out.
Not a wing.
Out.
Kirby would.
Out.
Brandon, learn to aim, you motherfucker.
Out.
Kirby,
like, God damn it.
The brain of Kirby.
You are trying to kill Kirby.
God damn it, Brandon. What are you doing?
Ow.
That's like right on the soft spot. I fear for the day when you eventually have children.
What? That's rude. Raccoon doll.
But how the fuck was that a raccoon? I don't know what the fuck that was, but that was no raccoon.
No, it looked like raccoon from, oh god, what was it? I think it was Rigby, that was it, yeah. I think that was Rigby from the regular show.
And they drown. How does iced tea or coffee get underwater?
Icy and coffee? What?
Yeah, you got a cup of coffee in the ocean.
Oh, he's dead.
Oh, it's water. Let's jump in.
Anyway.
Or suplex action. And oh hey, green beans.
Yes.
Gotta eat your vegetables.
Eh, not down there. There's a treasure chest right there.
Oh,
and you
God.
Just dropped a ton of enemies in it.
All of them survived except for the little squid.
Out.
Which actually keeps coming back from the sky.
Shell whistle.
Is that the freaking shell from Slowbro?
Or
Slowpoke?
I don't think there's any Pokemon references in this game.
Well, although it looks like it, though.
Yeah, that's what I was trying to think. Was Pokemon around by this time?
I believe so. Maybe? I believe it was.
Got
I'm sure somebody will check on that.
Yeah, I'll check it.
And that someone is Ryan.
That's me. Anyway, what was... God damn it.
More coffee.
Now I can just fucking imagine like Kirby like getting all like young, all hyper from all the coffee he was drinking.
Oh god, that's all we need. Kirby on a caffeine high.
Oh,
as if the lollipop wasn't bad enough. Yeah, I had to make another jump cut there just because I was spending ungodly amount of time trying to figure out how to get the treasure chest, and I just said screw it.
Okay.
Oh, okay. All right. So Pokemon was first created in 1995.
And when did this come out?
Wasn't this game made in 1998?
Oh, well.
Because I know the Game Boy Color was already out before Superstar, because that's when Kirby's Dream Land came out. I feel like it was 1998. I might be wrong.
Well, let's see. Kirby of the Stars Super Deluxe in Japan is a 1996 platforming video game.
Oh, 96, okay.
So hey, who knows? Maybe that was supposed to be a sudden
Pokemon reference. Okay.
Wait, alright, what?
Danny has no clue what this is.
I even want to know?
I believe,
I understand that Japan doesn't have nearly as much of the racial issues like we do.
But okay, let's not go there.
I still have to ask, what in the actual fuck am I looking at?
I believe it's official name.
Speaking of Pokemon references, hey, Jinx, how's it going?
And it's like, uh-huh.
What happened to your hands? Actually, now that I think about it, I wonder if this particular boss battle is how Sakurai got his inspiration for Master Hand in Smash Brothers.
Maybe.
Anyway, sorry about that. I believe its official name is Wham Bam Rock.
Wham Bam, thank you, ma'am.
Get on the floor, Jam.
You see me on the microphone.
I missed trolley time. My bad. Anyway.
Still trolley time! Run over shit!
There you go.
Yes, the trolley that climbs upwards and defies gravity.
Oh my god, I think that's it.
The what?
Wait.
Maria.
Please?
What? Waiting for exactly the what?
Yes! We are gone! We are out of here!
Okay. I thought it was, never mind. I thought it was probably something more outrageous.
We are free!
Oh, wait.
That is the Great Cave Offensive. It? Yeah, that's it.
Huzzah!
No, that's a little anticlimactic.
Yeah, I just realized that gold coin, that's Meow's coin on top of his head.
I think we made that joke already.
Oh, did we? Oh, it's been so long. Well, it feels like it.
At least at the time of this recording, anyway.
Yeah.
So yeah, that was the Great Cave Offensive, and we're getting an overview of all the treasures that we collected. Yeah,
the Great Cave Offensive, in which there was very little cave.
But lots and lots of castles.
So I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah, and lots of unedited backtracking.
That's not... I get it, I'm a noob at editing.
It's okay.
Anyway.
We still love you! Okay.
I appreciate that. Falcon Helmet.
Well, yeah, that was...
Mirror of Truth. Star Tiara. The Koopa Shell.
There's...
Sword. Warrior Shield. Unicorn Horn. Autumn Time.
Well, yeah, the Great Cave Offensive. Yeah, just like what Danny said, there wasn't too many caves out there, but I'm sure that last boss battle, that's got to be offensive.
Oh, maybe that's why? I am a terrible person. I am a terrible person. Well, yeah, that took so much, I don't want to sit here and say that the Great Cave Offensive is a very bad mode, because by all respect, it's not. It's just my least favorite mode out of every single one in this game. Like, as you all saw, I had the most trouble with this one so far than I did with any other.
Well, it does take... this one really it was an emphasis on exploring, and if you're not the kind of person that wants to take their time and explore everything, I imagine you probably will get very bored.
Yeah, but... Anyway, that's it for the Great Cave Offensive, and for this part of Kirby Superstar. Next time, we get to do one of the most fun modes of Kirby Superstar, the Revenge of Meta Knight. We'll see you guys then. Till next time, guys.